Hello everyone. In this session, we'll discuss about types and use of inheritance. So here we have some important video questions. Illustrate with the example a superclass variable can reference a subclass object. This is for 6 marks. This we already discussed in the previous video. And second one, elucidate the concept, that is explain the concept of inheritance and its classifications in Java with sketches. Okay, this is for 6 marks. So we'll discuss about this now. Types of inheritance. So first one is single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, multiple inheritance, and hybrid inheritance. Single inheritance. In single inheritance, there is only one parent class per derived class. So here we have class B, which is a derived class or child class, or it's also called a subclass, which is derived from class A. Okay, if class B is derived from class A, then it is a derived class. Okay, if it is a means what say if if mother has blue eyes. Okay, if your mother has blue eyes and if your child is also having blue eyes, then what is that? It is said that that is child inherits properties of mother. Okay, so class B has whatever the if we have variables and methods in class A, and that can be accessible inside class B, okay, using inheritance concept. So and this is what a base class. Class A is base class or parent class, or it's also called a super class. So one parent class per derived class. So if class B has only one parent class, then it is what? Single inheritance. One parent class per derived class. Second one, multi-level inheritance. When a derived class is derived from base class, so say I have class C, which is the derived class, and it is derived from class B, and it's what class B is a base class of class C, right? Which itself is a derived class. Okay, means for class B is what derived class, derived from class A. So which is base class. Okay, means what? Here class is derived from class B and class B is derived from class A. So then it is what? A multi-level inheritance. Okay, so when a derived class is derived from a base class, which itself is a derived class, then that type of inheritance is called multi-level inheritance. So let me take an example. So here here inheritance demo one is what? It is a main class because it contains main method, right? So outside this main class, I'll define a class A, okay? And in this class A, I'll declare a variable A, okay? And then so variable A is declared as integer. I'll take one method set_A. This method is to initialize the variable A, okay, to set the variable A. And then in this set A, okay, so I'll pass some parameter here. I'll pass parameter from main class. Later I'll pass the parameter. Now I will declare a variable I, and here A is equal to I semicolon, right? And so this is what now I value of I is assigned to A. Now I doesn't have any value as of now. We'll pass the value later in inside main class. And then I'll create one more method in here, void disk_A display method. Okay, and then sysout control space the value of A. The value of A is equal to is A. Okay, so now here we are just displaying the value of A here, right? So now I'll take so to explain inheritance concept, I need one more class, right? So class B, I'll copy everything. So I'll copy it here, copy and paste it here. So instead of A, use B, variable B, and set_B and disp_B is So these two are user defined names, set underscore b and disp underscore b are user defined names. Okay, and then so this and here the value of b is equal to b, right? So and here b is equal to I, right? So this is what a class b, right? Now so I to access members of class b, I had to create the object of class b. To access members of class a, that is to access variable a and set a method and this underscore a method, I had to create the object of class a. So but here okay, but now I'll just create the object now of class b. How to create the object? Class name space object name obj underscore b is equal to new b class name semicolon and bracket semicolon, right? And then obj underscore b dot, so I can access the member of class b now, set underscore b I. So I'll take value 10 now, right? And then obj underscore b dot set underscore b. One more method, I'll list how to display this method. Dot dist underscore b, right? So now the value of b is set now, b is set to 10. So I'm passing parameter 10 here. Okay, here I'm passing parameter 10, right? So now what is, let me run this program. So the answer is the value of b is equal to 10 because I have passed 10 here, right? Now can I access, now the question is, can I access the member of class a here? Let me check that. Obj underscore b dot set underscore a, right? And 20. Well, I'll write take 20 now. So I'm trying to set the value of variable a, which is inside class a, right? By using object b. So here it is showing error. What is that error? The method set of a of int is undefined for the type b. Means what? Set underscore a method is not defined inside class b. So now how to remove this error now? By using inheritance concept. So here class b extends a, right? And don't write class b extends class a. This is wrong. Okay, so this is wrong way to inherit the class. So you had to inherit like this only, class b extends a. Okay, and then and here inside the, so now I can, now it is not showing any error because I have used extends keyword. So inheritance means what? You had to use extends keyword. Extends class a means what? Class b is what? Class b is derived class or subclass or child class, one and the same. And class a is base class or parent class or super class, one and the same, right? So now I don't have any error now. So obj underscore b dot disp underscore b, right? So I'm just displaying the value of a. Let me display the value of a here. So what is the value of a now? 20. So what is the answer? The value of a is equal to 20. So now a value is displayed here. So here 20 value is passed as a parameter to which argument? I argument, right? Which is inside class b, this one. So I is equal to 20 and b is equal to, sorry, a, right? I is equal to 20 and a is equal to 20, right? So now let me perform some mathematical operation. So here inside class b, I can perform mathematical operation. If you want to manipulate any data which is inside class a, you had to do that inside the subclass. Okay, you can do that inside subclass only. So now you can implement that now. What is that? What is that implementation? Multiplication. Okay, let me take multiplication method. Okay, and here I'll declare one more variable called mul underscore result, multiplication result, semicolon. And so now mul underscore result is declared as integer. And now I'll perform operation control space is equal to a plus a into b semicolon. So now I had to print this out, control space, the value of mul underscore, okay, mul underscore res is equal to this plus mul underscore result, right? So now how to, now if I run this, I'll get the same output because I haven't called the method, right? So I can call that method, I had to call that method using obj underscore b only. What is that? Multiplication, right? So now what is the answer? 10 into 20, it is 200. Yes, answer is 200. So next, now this is what single inheritance. What am I doing here? In class A, I have a variable A and method set A and display A method, right? Two methods here, set A method and display A method and variable A. Now I'm accessing, without creating the object of class A, I'm accessing method set A and display A, okay, using object B. Using object B, okay, obj B, I can access the member of class A, okay, using inheritance concept. So here it is a single inheritance. Means what? One parent class per derived class, that is class B, right? So now what is that multi-level inheritance? So here we have discussed what is that multi-level inheritance. So class is derived from class B. Class B is again it is derived from class A. It's a base class, and which is derived again, which itself is derived from class A, which is base class, right? So let me take one more. I need one more class for this. So let me take a class C now. Okay, class C. Yes. And in this class C, I'll declare one more variable in C semicolon, and void set underscore C. Set underscore C, and here I'll just copy paste everything. Okay, instead of typing it again, I'll just copy this and paste it here. So I'll perform different mathematical operation now. Instead of multiplication, I'll perform some addition operation. Okay. So I had to replace this variable B by C, set underscore C, C is equal to I, this underscore C, value of C is equal to C, and instead of multiplication, I'll perform addition operation, sum, and then sum result, sum result. Now here A plus B plus C, sum result, right? And so now I can access this sum result, that is sum method, inside I'll just call that method now, obj underscore. So I had to create the object of class C now. How to create the object? Obj underscore C is equal to new C semicolon. Okay, obj underscore C dot set C. So let me take 30 now. Okay, the value of C is set to 30 now, and obj underscore C dot disp underscore C, right? So let me just run this program. So the value of C is equal to 35. Now I'll call that method addition, sum method, okay, dot sum. So now let me check what is the expected output. 10 into 20, 20 plus 20 plus 30, that is 60. But here we will get this showing error. Because here there is an error, a plus b plus c. Okay, extends, I haven't used extends here. Class C extends class B. Okay, class C extends class B. No error now. Okay, let me run this. So the value of mul result, not mul result, now this is sum result, so change it to sum result. So next run this is equal to 30. I'm getting 30. Actually the expected output is 60, but here I'm getting 30 because here if you check the value of A and B inside a sum method of class C, okay, sys out, I'll just show you the variable value, plus A plus B is equal to plus B, right? So I'll just run this now. So plus plus concatenation operation, concatenation operator done. So B is equal to, also make sure to leave some space here to separate variable A and variable B, and then click on run. So A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, because here we in main class we have created the object of class B, right? So yeah, that is why I'll change it to class C, obj underscore C. Okay, so so when you create, why am I changing this? Because so when subclass, when we have a subclass, then you can just create the object of subclass only to access the members of superclass. We don't have to create the object of superclass. So here subclass is what? Class C is subclass, right? And so obj underscore C, set underscore C, and then underscore C, C, C. Okay, so now this is not required because it's already created there. So I'll remove this. So now I don't have any error. Now let me check the answer. It is A is equal to 20, B is equal to 0, because so here the value of A, set underscore C, here it is A, B, and this is B, right? Let me make it B, and here C, right? So A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, and C is equal to 30. Now we'll check the answer. A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, correct? And C is equal to 30. So if you perform addition operation, 10 plus 20 plus 30 is 60. So I'm getting the answer now. So in the previous example, we have got error because we have created the object of class B, and we have initialized, we had set the value of A and B, right? And so when it goes to subclass, then obviously what will happen, that will be zero. Okay, the value of variable private members, that is private members of superclass and superclass, okay, will be zero. So but you can access the variables inside class C, but so since we have created the object of class B, we have got 0 0, A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0. So that is why you have to access, so you had to create the object of subclass in order to access the members of superclass. Okay, whenever if you make use of inheritance concept, so make sure to use create the object of subclass only. So now the question is, here class B extends class A, correct? Fine. If I remove this now, okay, let me remove class C extends B. So can I access the members of class B inside class C? Answer is no, I cannot access, because inheritance concept is not used here. So if I use class C extends class B, now I can access the members of class B and class A inside class C. Okay, I'll repeat it now. So when class C is what? It's a class C subclass or derived class, right? Class B is what? Derived class of a derived class, and which is derived from class B or subclass, one and the same, or subclass, right? So class C is, so when class C is extends class B, means what? We can access the members of class A and class B inside class C only when class B extends class A. I mean, Here class B extends, right? So if class B does not extend class A, okay, if class B does not inherit the properties of class A, then I cannot access the members of class A in class C. Okay, so only I can access the members of class A in class C only when class B inherits or extends the class B extends class A. Okay, so that is what this is what multi-level inheritance means. What here class C is what? It is a derived class. Class C is a derived class which is derived from class B, and class B itself derived from class A. So then it is what? Multi-level inheritance. Okay, so like this. So next one, multiple inheritance. Does it support? Does Java support multiple inheritance? We'll see that it does. It does not support multiple inheritance. Java does not support multiple inheritance. In multiple inheritance, the derived class is derived from more than one base class. Okay, so means what? Here we have class C, which is a derived class, and it is derived from class A and class B, and those two classes are base classes. Okay, class A and class B are base classes, and this is what class C is, derived class or subclass or child class, and this is what super class, or these two are super class or base class, or so it's a or base classes, right? And next we will see hybrid inheritance. The combination of multi-level inheritance and multiple inheritance leads to hybrid inheritance, right? So here class C is what? It's a derived class, and which is derived from class B, and it is a base class of class C, right? Class B is a base class of class C, and class C is also derived from class B, and it's a base class of class C. And now class B is derived from class A, which is base class now. So now this type of, now here we have multi-level inheritance as well as multiple inheritance, right? So this type of inheritance is called as a hybrid inheritance. It leads to hybrid inheritance. So combination of both multi-level and multiple inheritance. Next question, does Java support multiple inheritance? So the answer is no. It does not support multiple inheritance because of diamond problem. Okay, you can check. You can just Google for it. What is diamond problem? Okay, and you can comment below. Why Java does not support multiple inheritance? And use of inheritance. Inheritance means taking some properties from the parent class, from the parents. That is, for example, if your mother has blue eyes and your eyes are also blue, then it is said that the color of your eyes is inherited. Java inheritance means derived class borrows some properties of base class. At the same time, the derived class may have some additional properties. The inheritance can be achieved by incorporating the definition of one class into the another class using the keyword extends. In object-oriented programming, the inheritance is referred as is a relation. Okay, so this is what use of inheritance. So hope you have understood. Illustrate with us example. A superclass variable can reference a subclass object. It's for 6 months. Take this example and explain. You can explain this. And second one, I explain the concept of inheritance. This we have covered just now, right? And you had to explain Java does not support multiple inheritance and hybrid inheritance. Okay, if it does, means what? What is that multiple inheritance means? Class B extends A, comma. So here class B extends A, fine. And here I have class C, right? Above this I have class A and class B. So multiple inheritance means class C extends B comma A. This is what multiple inheritance. Okay, B comma A, make use of comma operator to separate two classes. But it assumes that Java does not support multiple inheritance. I cannot write like this for Java. Okay, this is Java does not support comma A, B comma A. Okay, so multiple inheritance is not possible, as well as hybrid inheritance also it's not possible. Okay, so it's all about today's session. Hope you have understood. If you have any doubt, please comment below. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more updates. Thank you so much for watching.